So up to this point, we've been using MGH for gravitational potential energy. But in the previous video, I discussed how this formula is actually more accurate. But it's strange because these formulas actually look quite different. For example, the distance away from the ground, h here, is in the numerator, whereas in this equation, the distance away from the center of the Earth, r down here, is in the numerator. That seems awfully strange. And this one is positive, and this one's negative. There are quite a few differences. So the question is, can these values really be similar? So we're going to do a problem where we're going to have to use both these formulas, and we're going to see if we get similar results over small distances. And then we're going to calculate the percent error by using this equation instead of this one. So let's imagine that we have a person here who's dropping a 1 kilogram ball off a 50 meter tall building. Now it turns out that this 1 kilogram mass doesn't actually matter to the final calculation, but we'll just throw it in there just to make our lives easier. I want you to solve for the kinetic energy of the ball at the bottom of this building using both of these forms of gravitational potential energy. Then once you've calculated the final kinetic energy using both of these formulas, I want you to tell me what's the percent error using MGH instead of this more general formula. You should put your answer in this box. And in order to solve this problem, you may need a few of these constants down below. Here's the value of g, here's the radius of the Earth in kilometers, and here's the mass of the Earth in kilograms. And just as a hint to get you started in the right direction, when you're using this formula, this r should be the radius of the Earth when the ball is at the bottom of the building, and should be equal to the radius of the Earth plus 50 meters when the ball is at the top of the building. Remember that this formula is from the ball to the center of the Earth, so we have to include the radius of the Earth in our calculations. Also, when you're solving this problem, be sure to use g equals 9.8 meters per second squared, rather than 10 meters per second squared, just to make our answer a bit more accurate. All right, good luck finding that percent error.